Well, let's take a look at the big races we're covering tonight.
The decisions you make will lead the country into the next 4 years. Maher Kawash is watching some of our biggest local races, and that starts with Washington's next governor, as Jay Inslee is trying to win a third term.
That's right, Nia, and his challenger, Republican Lauren Culp, is the police chief from Republic. He's new to politics and riding the strength of a grassroots campaign. He would be the first Republican to become Washington's governor since 1980. Our Republican Congresswoman Kathy McMorris Rogers is seeking her ninth term representing Washington's 5th congressional district. Her challenger is Democrat Dave Wilson, looking to become the first Democrat to fill that seat since 1994, when then Speaker of the House Tom Foley lost to George Nethercutt. And then Washington voters will be deciding on Referendum 90, a measure on sex ed curriculum in public schools. If passed, it would require public schools to provide age-appropriate sex education for all kids in grades K through 12. Now, more than $2.5 million were raised in campaign funds for and against this sex ed bill. That's just unheard of. Now, we've also never seen a ballot measure have such strong opposition on both sides of it. Just about every Republican in the state has said this bill would sexualize children too much, whereas Democrats and health organizations say it's critical for development.
Now, Maher, the race for governor has seen an unusual lack of spending this year, right?
That's right. Usually around this point in the campaign, there would be many more millions of dollars poured in. As of right now, Jay Inslee raised about $8 million to this point, and some of that was from his past campaigns. Lauren Culp raised $3.1 million, had to spend about $2.9 of that, and a political expert from Washington State University says the lack of spending in this governor's race this year is because of the competitiveness of this race. Many big donors don't expect that race to be very close, therefore, they don't want to put their money back into it.